1945, United States has dropped two nuclear bombs on two cities of Japan. And for the first time, the whole world had experienced the power of nuclear weapon. And it became a history. We all remember this day as a Hiroshima Day. So friends, welcome to your very own channel, sonisinghphysics. In this video, we are going to talk about atomic bomb and basics of nuclear energy. On September 1, 1939, Hitler invaded Poland from east. 2 days later, Britain and France declared war against Germany, and that was the foundation of Second World War. Second World War was the biggest war in the history. On September 17, Soviet troops invaded Poland from east. Around 75 million people died. Duration of this war was 1st September 1939 to 2nd September 1945. So in this video, we are going to see some evidential questions about Second World War also. First question is, what was the smaller bomb dropped over Japan? It was Little Boy. Little Boy was the code name for the type of atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima on 6th August 1945 during World War II. It was the first nuclear weapon used in warfare. Like Thin Man, it was a gun-type fission weapon. Next question is, what was the biggest atomic bomb? The biggest atomic bomb was Tsar Bomba, means Russian meaning king of bombs. It is the Soviet thermonuclear bomb that was detonated in a test over Novaya Zemlya Island in the Arctic Ocean on October 30, 1961. It produced the most powerful human-made explosion ever recorded. The bomb was dropped to descent by parachute from a TV-95V aircraft and detonated autonomously 4,000 meters or 13,000 feet above the island. Next question is, what was the bomb to be detonated in space? And it was Starfish Prime. On 9th July 1962, the United States conducted Starfish Prime nuclear test aimed at testing the effects of nuclear weapons in high altitude or lower outer space. The explosion took place 400 km above the Johnson Atoll in the northern Pacific Ocean. It had an explosive yield of 1.45 megatons, approximately 100 times that of the Hiroshima bomb. Next question is, what are the materials needed to make an atom bomb? And materials are uranium and plutonium. Uranium-238 and plutonium-239. Next question is, what was the name of American's project to develop an atomic bomb? And it was the Manhattan Project, which was the code name for the American-led effort to develop a functional atomic weapon during World War II. What was the name of the B-29 bomber which dropped the first atomic bomb? And it is the Enola Gay. The Enola Gay, the plane that dropped an atomic bomb on Hiroshima, Japan on August 6, 1945. The B-29, also called Super Fortress, was a four-engine heavy bomber that was built by Boeing. With what force did Little Boy explode? And it exploded with the force of 15,000 tons of TNT. This gun-type uranium bomb weighed 9,700 pounds. The bomb was dropped from 31,000 feet. The bomb exploded about 1500 feet above the city with a force of 15,000 tons of TNT. TNT means trinitrotoluene. It is one of the most popular explosive compounds. Friends, if you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Press the notification bell to get all the updates as soon as possible. Let us learn a little more about structure of an atom and its constituent before we understand the production of electricity from nuclear energy. Atom is a basic unit of matter and it has a dense central part known as nucleus. Nucleus contains positive charge particles, proton, and neutral particles, neutron. Nucleus is surrounded by a cloud of negatively charged particles, that is, electrons. All stable atoms of a single element have the same number of protons or electrons. Number of protons in an atom is known as atomic number, and we represent it with the alphabet Z. Sum of the number of neutrons and protons in the nucleus of an atom is known as atomic mass or mass number, and we represent it with alphabet capital A. An atom of copper element is significantly written as copper 2958. But within a single element, the number of neutrons in the nucleus may vary. Such atoms that have different atomic mass number but same atomic number are called isotopes of the element. The simplest example of isotopes is the hydrogen isotope 1H1, common form of hydrogen and is scientifically known as protium, which has atomic number 1 and atomic mass number 1. It consists of one proton and one electron. When a hydrogen isotope contains one neutron in addition to a proton in its nucleus, known as deuterium or heavy hydrogen, that is 1H2. The hydrogen isotope within two neutrons is called tritium, that is 1H3. Now we will come to know what is heavy water, because heavy water has a very significant role in production of nuclear energy. We know that water, that is H2O, is formed by the combination of hydrogen and oxygen. Ordinary water, that is H2O, is sometimes referred as light water. Heavy water is a term which is usually referred to deuterium oxide, D2O, formed by the combination of deuterium, that is 1H2, and oxygen. It has different physical and similar chemical properties to that of water. Naturally occurring water contains about 0.015% heavy water and 99.885% light water. That is, 1.5 liter of heavy water is 10,000 liters of natural water. Now we'll discuss about nuclear energy. As we know that each element have isotopes. Some isotopes are stable and some isotopes are unstable. Nuclear energy is the result of conversion from unstable isotopes into stable isotope. During this conversion, elements radiate energy, and that energy is called radioactivity. Radioactivity takes place with the help of three particles, that is alpha, beta, and gamma. Alpha is the least harmful one, beta is more than that, and gamma is the most harmful particle for us, because gamma contains maximum energy. However, few unstable isotopes of uranium and plutonium undergoes fission transformation, that is, splitting into two or more atoms of different elements, with the release of huge amount of energy when bombarded with neutrons. This huge amount of energy released or comes out of the nucleus of an atom is generally known as nuclear energy. The huge energy is a part of energy that is keeping the protons and neutrons bound together in the nucleus of an atom, and that is known as binding energy. If a U-35 nucleus splits into two or more with absorption of neutron, a part of binding energy of the nucleus is converted into the form of kinetic energy of the fragment, means small atoms. The kinetic energy of fragments gets converted into heat energy and released in the medium. Nuclear energy is generated by splitting the isotopes of heavy elements like uranium, thorium, and plutonium. Though all isotopes of these elements cannot be split, some isotopes like uranium-233, uranium-235, and uranium-238, then thorium-232, and plutonium-239, plutonium-240, and plutonium-245 are used in the field of nuclear technology. The process of splitting of an atom into two or more fragments is known as fission. Isotopes which readily undergo fission are called fissile isotopes. Examples are uranium-233, uranium-235, and plutonium-239. Isotopes such as thorium-232 and uranium-238 do not readily undergo fission, but an absorption of a neutron, they get converted into fissile isotope like uranium-233 and plutonium-239. Such isotopes are known as fertile isotopes. Now we'll come to know about what are the important parts of nuclear power plant. In a nuclear power plant, reactor core, control rods, coolant and containment. These are five important sections of a nuclear power plant. Reactor is the main steel vessel containing the nuclear fuel, the moderator and the coolant. Reactor core is the central part of a nuclear reactor where fuel is located and fission chain reaction is occurring. Control rods are the device to absorb neutron and thereby terminate or control chain reaction in the reactor core. Materials such as boron, cadmium, etc. are used as control rods. Coolant is a liquid or gas used to remove the heat from the reactor core. Containment, that is leak-tight hemispherical structure which houses the reactor and other components of the reactor plant. All the modern reactors including Kundakulam have two containments, inner and other containments. It is to protect the reactor from external events like flood, tsunami, earthquake, explosion, plane crash, etc. They also act as barrier against release of radioactivity to environment. Friends, thank you for watching this video. I hope this video will be helpful for you. Thank you.